What does globalization have to do with languages in sci-fi? I recently stumbled upon an article, and being a linguist, but also a sci-fi fan, I had to share my thoughts with you. Quote, imagine a sci-fi novel where an AI helps design an alien language spoken by an advanced race contacting Earth. The AI studies features of real languages like Swahili and Mandarin, then innovates, blending Earth elements with alien grammar and sounds, unlike anything we know. The result is a language ringing with originality. No mere code or cipher, but an intricate tongue for discourse between worlds. AI as creator allows science fiction to breach new frontiers in alien linguistics. End quote. It sounds awesome, doesn't it? Let's be honest. AI can only work with the data it's been fed. But our understanding of language is limited to what we know and document. But you see, countless languages are unknown because they have never been documented. The scientific community and the general public, as a consequence, are not aware of countless languages because nobody has sat down and documented them. For some, we still have a chance because the languages themselves are still alive, but for others, we will never know how they were, because they are dead. It may sound a bit odd to speak about languages in this way, but this is kind of the terminology that we have in linguistics, in which a language that is alive is a language that has speakers, a community. It has been established and it's used in schools, in communication of all kinds, in institutions, it's being recognized at a national level, and so on. Whereas an endangered language, so a language that is about to die or it's getting close to that point, is one that may have a very small community. It may not be written and documented. It may not have any status, any official status in the region, for instance, and several other things. And how does a language become endangered? Well, in some cases, speakers have been forced to replace their languages. This is the case with colonialism, but also globalization, because when it comes to colonialism, you have a foreign power that imposes their language to the colonized community. And so there is this kind of suppression. In history, we know about languages that have been forbidden. Some of them are lost in time, we will never retrieve them. Some others have been saved. And so this process can be reversed. And when it comes to globalization, it's more a matter of convenience. So it's no longer convenient to use a certain language if it's not available on your device, your laptop, your smartphone, if it's not used on a daily basis because there is no reason for using it. Or perhaps your community is getting smaller and smaller because of globalization, and this means that the language is getting smaller and smaller too. So there are so many factors, and you may look into social linguistics for other possible reasons for languages to disappear. And again, one of them is that there are no longer speakers of the language, so they all passed. And you may ask, what about written evidence? Well, it's way less common than you might think, because a lot of languages in the world are not written yet and have never been written. Some have recently adopted a script, such as Arabic or the Latin script, and they have tried to apply that to the languages, so their sound system and their grammar, which is a process that takes time, because yes, you may impose a grammar or a writing system to the community, but then if the people do not use it, there's no point, and the language will not be officially standardized because people are not using it that way. So that process takes time, it's not as simple as it may sound. So before being able to document a language and get a grammar, a textbook to give to students in schools, a dictionary, or a corpus that will then be used to feed AI, you see, there are several steps before reaching the point in which we have enough data on a language that can be then used by AI. Now that we have established that not all languages are written, not all languages are documented and standardized, you see that we don't really know all the possible features that languages may have, because these may be hidden in some language that either has died or is out there but it's not documented and it's not available to the scientific community or the general public. And this means that these features are not available to AI either. In the end, linguistic studies are biased, and you have definitely more European languages or other majority languages such as Mandarin or Hindi that can be fed AI. And this applies to generative AI too, because it might invent language systems, yes, but it will always lack the richness of natural languages, because we don't even know how rich they can be. And it may create alien-sounding languages, yes, but they might not hold up under closer inspection. That being said, if you are a writer who is looking into ways to write your conlang, which is another word for invented or fictional languages, you might look into VulgarLang. It's a tool, a website, an application that I haven't used, but I heard about it from other indie writers as an awesome tool, because especially if you're not a linguist and you still want to incorporate these alien-sounding features or fantasy traits in your novel through language, this is the perfect system for you, because it allows you to create both sound systems and even alphabets based on your preferences. It's a generator and it's designed specifically for fantasy, but I think it might apply to sci-fi as well, because in the end your goal is to create languages that are quite far from natural languages, and that applies to both. So if you have tried VulgarLang already, let me know what you think. There is a demo version, so you can try it without paying, but it might be worth it, especially if you're a writer. And so while AI-generated languages can captivate audiences, they still come with limitations, so we're not at that point yet with AI. And the richness of human languages, many of which remain undocumented, cannot be fully replicated by AI yet. And if you want to create truly convincing alien languages, perhaps you might want to study linguistics instead, or use tools such as this VulgarLang, and accept the fact that you don't have full access to all possible features, because AI hasn't been fed those yet. So what do you think? Will AI ever be able to truly replicate the complexity of human languages? And will it be able to invent languages that might be useful for actual communication with aliens? Please let me know what you think down below. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.